First item is apologies for absence. I've received apologies from Councillor Joe Bird, Councillor Irene Williams, is the Councillor Joe.
Can move on Sunday. Can move also on a phone call from Eugene Stevenson, who's had number four this afternoon.
Thank you.
presentation.
Thank you, Chair. I'm really delighted to be here to present our culture programme, culture strategy. I've got a presentation in terms of the report that was sent to committee. I gave some headlines around our evaluation from our imagined Wirral year last year, and also kind of as we've moved into Wirral culture, what the things around that are. But to bring that to life, these commissioners, it's really great to show the images and some of the footage and kind of what we've been doing. This year, hopefully, members will be aware that the world is more relationship with the city region, and I'll talk a little bit about that as we go through the presentation. But firstly, I think the appendix to the report is our evaluation from last year. So in terms of looking back at our achievements and successes from the Imagine Wirral in 2018, we really feel this was a landmark year for celebrating our culture and heritage in Wirral, and it marked the first year that a creative programme of events had been developed for the Wirral by the Council in collaboration with partners and stakeholders. Some of those things you can see pictured there. So events like the Giant Spectacular, which we worked on with Culture Liverpool, and other events, it was a real opportunity to kind of put those under umbrella branding and really make a statement about what we were trying to achieve. Major events included the three festivals, Torchships Regatta in May, Giant Spectacular, a fantastic exhibition, You Write Your Businesses, and You Write, which brought together the work of three internationally renowned photographers. We have a number of light annual fireworks spectacular, and a range of community events across the year. We really do feel that the Imagine Wirral really caught the imagination of people and started to introduce people to the idea of thinking differently about Wirral as a place. And I'll talk a little bit about, if that's okay, to talk about a little bit about our evaluation findings and what actually those events mean in terms of impact. This is the numbers. Over 250,000 visitors attracted to Wirral as a direct result of those events. Giant Spectacular, as you can imagine, made a significant contribution to that of 80,000 visitors. But collectively, that's a quarter of a million people who came to events and saw what a fantastic art we've got here in Wirral. That was both residents and visitors from elsewhere. Obviously, a key statistic for us and a key part of our evaluation of every event that we do and the wider programme is the economic impact of what we're doing. Events are brilliant, it's actually a great prize, and they are something to enjoy, but they actually bring on massive amounts of economic return. So, for every pound that we invested in culture last year as a local authority, we had £25 worth of economic return. So, that's from businesses benefiting, and that's from the amount of, again, that economic impact and what that means for the local area, and that's a really important statistic for us. We secured a huge amount of external funding last year to support the programme, so alongside the Council's investment in culture, we had a significant Arts Council grant, and we've done that again this year. And we also work really collaboratively with partners in a creative way to maximise the resources that were available to support events. High satisfaction levels last year, 85% based on the quality of events good or very good, 100% for Giants. We placed a real focus on engagement and participation, which we are continuing to drive forward this year. Over 700 school children participated directly in the programme, that was through real intervention, close intervention of the events. We had hundreds of volunteers supporting the programme. One of the highlights in terms of volunteer engagement was the Moss Castles project, which took place in West Kirby, which was our amazing Karl castle, which I hope people will see images of. Hundreds of people contributed to building that castle over the course of the preparatory week and then the build day, and then as part of the weekend, it was a real celebration of community as well as that great art So moving on to our Bureau of Culture Year. The theme for our Bureau of Culture Year is discovery, exploration and the great outdoors. And we really wanted to, and I'll talk a little bit about city region principles that have driven this, but one of them is distinctiveness of place. So it really was about what actually makes Wirral this place really special, really unique. And a really key thing that's happening at the moment is the survey back from Mayville to Cllr, which I think kind of encapsulates our maritime shipbuilding heritage, but also that idea of place of Wirral, innovation, of furs, of the industry, of manufacturing. And the great outdoors bringing that in, our open spaces, our parks, which are an absolutely massive asset for Wirral in terms of both our resident population and our visitor economy. And we really wanted to showcase all of that during 2019. So I mentioned our City Region Borough Culture, and this was an initiative brought forward through the City Region Culture and Creativity Partnership, and some funding from the Combined Authority has been devolved to us alongside this. And the principles that we need to work within around that initiative are children, young people, positive outcomes, communities, distinctiveness of place, which I mentioned, infrastructure. So all things when you think about culture, creativity and the arts, this is about engaging the whole population, real focus on what that can mean for children, young people, and also thinking about communities and how we can work with them in terms of this agenda. So it's a really, really good broad framework within which to work. And a really key one, and I'll talk a little bit about legacy at the end, is that this year could just be a great program of events that everybody can enjoy, but how we leave the legacy for the future through what we're doing around culture and creativity. That is absolutely critical to what we're doing. And so ambitions for this year, building on last year, we want to double those audiences in terms of people attending or being part of events, increase the economic impact, increase the PR reach, and the extent of that publicity side of things, and increase the participation. We want hundreds of volunteers and thousands of participants. We'll be building on that already. We've got a great and growing volunteer cohort program who's getting involved in all of our events, which is great. So just to review what we've done so far this year, and hopefully some of these images and events will be familiar. Animated Square in March, which we ran originally as part of Tall Ships for Gas last year, what really encapsulated what we wanted to do around creativity and cultural events. You know, it's an astonishing thing to see and hear and be part of. A video protection onto a building, a map onto a building, but it was very, very much about the story of the place, what the editorials and references to the Vikings there. It was a really, really, really fantastic piece. So, for last year, I think we had